So today we will start with another part of evolution of tourism. It is modern antecedents to or ancient antecedents to modern tourism. Yes. So before the modern tourism has developed, what were the forms of tourism? Before the modern tourism, yes, it has changed. Modern tourism is a changed tourism, but it is in continuity with the earlier tourism, earlier form of tourism. Yes, what were happening in ancient times? Any form of tourism was there? A very, very special and very basic form of tourism was
बोर्ड दिख रहा है आपको nomadism. What is nomadism?
Can anyone tell me what is nomadism? Can you see the board? Can you hear me? Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir.
So what is nomadism? Perhaps nomadism was earliest form of tourism, one of the earliest forms of tourism. What is nomadism?
Sir, nomadism may be ye ho sakta hai ki jo panjari log ghumte the ek jagah se dusri jagah for the settlement.
Yes, you are right, exactly. It was a form of migration and tourism. It was nomadism. The man was a nomad. Why क्यों घूमते थे वो? Yes.
Sir, for the business purpose, for the settlement.
Business came later. In nomadism time, in the earliest time, why they were frequently migrating? Yes. Why they were frequently migrating?
सर क्योंकि बहुत सारी जगहों पे मतलब सीजनल चेंजेस होता था जिसकी जगह खाना रहना
सीजनल चेंजेस एंड एंड व्हाट वाज द प्राइम रीजन ऑफ नोमैडिज्म यस व्हाट वाज द प्राइम रीजन ऑफ नोमैडिज्म
फूड
Yes, food. So food was available there, then that's why they were settled there. Then what happened? Yes.
Sir, maybe agreement with king or Johan.
That came later. That came later. In nomadic times, mainly there were no modern states. They developed later. At least if they were modern states, they were in primary form. Yes. So king was not a figure as we know the king these days. Yes, I think Yusra have to say something about it. She said something about this. Yes, Yusra. Rifat said something. Who pointed out food?
So when they used to live earlier at the place, they moved to another place. The land
first part of your sentence, I was unable to hear. Can you repeat it? Yes, Yusra.
जब जिस जगह पे वो पहले वहाँ हो जाता था.
Yes. When the your voice is breaking up, perhaps because of internet. So when we can say that when the resources like food, resources like fertile soil, resources like irrigation, resources like other
basic amenities got depleted because of intense use. Because of intense use. So, they have developed a paucity of resources, lack of proper resources. Then they moved to other places, to other untouched places. This mainly happened in what we call it mainly? There was a special agricultural practice.
Yes. Agriculture, sir.
Shifting agriculture, exactly. So why we shifted? Why we use that practice? Because the fertility of the soil got depleted. Why the fertility of the soil got depleted? Can anyone tell me?
Continuously used to grow crops on the same land, and therefore the nutrients which became
But yes, you are very right. But in modern times, we form the same field year after year. Why it is not happening now?
Because sir, we are adding.
Yes, exactly. We are adding. I think you are saying that we are adding fertilizer. We are replenishing or recharging the soil with the nutrients which were depleted in those times. Then there was no fertilizer, a proper use of fertilizer was there. And other resources also got depleted. Other resources like animals, food, animals as food and other things, they got depleted. Or sometimes they shifted because of climate change, a natural calamity, or famine, or a flood, and in. So they, in strict terms of, if you get the definition very strictly, it was not tourism; it was migration, isn't it? But in those times, if we relax our definition a little, then you can say that it was migration and tourism sometimes overlap. We talked about it. Often overlap. Okay. So nomadism was a very earlier form of, a primitive form of tourism. So it was an antecedent tourism. Yes. Nomadism. Yes. And then one earlier form, and which is practiced today also, it is pilgrimage. What is pilgrimage? Yes. What is pilgrimage? Yes. What is pilgrimage?
So religious places mein jaate hain, long journey.
Religious places that I will prefer the term holy places. There are some holy there are some places which are considered holy or sacred places. Holy or sacred. They think that it is their religious duty to go to holy or sacred places. Yes, that was a very early form of, when the organized religion was not there, then also this type of tourism happened. If you go to Stonehenge is one of the wonders of the world. If you ask around to guide and local people, they will tell you that it was perhaps a site of like a sacred ancient place. So people used to visit it as holy places. Other places in India, we can find many places. There are many sacred forests also in India. So pilgrimage, and it happens to this day also. Does it happen or not?
Yes, sir.
It is an important part of Indian tourism or not?
Yes, sir.
It is an important part of Indian tourism. Yes. Religious tourism circuit is very, very important, and government is focusing on that. And pilgrimage is in Islam also. We go on Hajj. That is a tourism. That is a religious duty, but it works like tourism, and it aids tourism. It increases the tourism, isn't it? It gives us all benefits of tourism. If we go to Haridwar and Rishikesh and other holy places, everywhere around the globe, sacred places are found. Some sacred forests are also there. It is very interesting that some temples are places of worship are considered more sacred or more holy than others. Does it happen? Yes. Does it happen? Yes. Does it happen? कुछ जगहों को, कुछ टेम्पल्स को, कुछ प्लेसेस ऑफ वर्शिप को बाकी प्लेसेस ऑफ वर्शिप से ज़्यादा होली माना जाता है, क्या ऐसा होता है? माय क्वेश्चन इज दैट यस इन अलीगढ़ इज देयर एनी प्लेस लाइक दैट यस इन अलीगढ़ इन विसिनिटी ऑफ अलीगढ़ यस Is there any place like that? Yes. Yes, Momita.
Sir, Ram Mandir.
In Aligarh, I think. In Aligarh.
Sir, center point पर एक मंदिर है जो बहुत पुरानी है. तो मैं भी
टीकाराम मंदिर. And any
yes,
other
sir.
temple? Any other temple in vicinity of Aligarh? Have you heard about the temple of Harishwar Mahadev? Have you heard about it? No.
No, sir.
There is a in Kher, and there is a Shiv temple, and on Shivratri you will see that people are thronging to that place. So that is the tourism also. So pilgrimage was an important part of tourism before modern times, and is also a part of tourism in modern times. Maybe the pattern of visiting those places got changed over times, because we have rapid transport now, and other our life pattern has changed, so it changed, but it is there. In modern time, before modern and modern, then there was a very, very important antecedent to modern tourism was travel for trade and business. Travel for trade and business. Yes, it was there or not? In modern time, it happens, but it was there or not in ancient times or medieval times? Yes sir. Yeah, it happened always. People go to places to explore that whether my business can be established here or not, and after they establish the business, they visit that place as a tourist also, and tourism also has developed in a big industry. It is one of the fastest growing industries of the world. Do you know that? Tourism, before pandemic, it was fastest growing industry of the world. And it will be again after the, it is picking up again, and after the pandemic is gone, hopefully, it will be, it will get a boost. What do you think? Tourism बढ़ जाएगा या कम हो जाएगा? अब लोगों को घर रहने की आदत पड़ गई है.
सर बढ़ जाएगा.
It will increase. It will get a boost, in my opinion. People will go on towards again and again. So travel or tourism for trade and business is, in fact, there is a very interesting term, perhaps we have talked about it earlier. There is a blazer. Have you heard about that term, blazer? Yes. Have you heard about that term, blazer? Have anyone heard about?
Yes, sir.
Yes. What is that?
Pleasure means
yes.
खुशी मिले. Pleasure. खुशी
is,
मिले.
Yeah, yes, yes, yes. You are right. It is the. It is the term is made from joining two terms, business and pleasure or leisure. Business and leisure. Leisure is disposable time and business. It is that leisure in which you perform business. Actually, by definition, leisure is not business. But modern times has modern definitions of things, and things are changing. So people go, people use leisure also for business. They sometimes use leisure to get business ideas, to get new business ideas. Yes. And perhaps biggest business ideas came from leisure. And then there is a very, very interesting travel for you can guess where I'm getting. Travel for
pleasure.
Yeah, travel for pleasure, yes. And travel for, I'm getting at travel for education and research. Can you give an example? Yes, travel for education and research. Yes. Can you give an example?
Sir, hum log.
Yes, we travel for education and research, and we go on educational tours, excursion, geographical tours, and in before modern times, can you give an example? This is
sir,
modern.
Archaeologist hote the.
Yeah, archaeologist. And any famous traveler.
Al-Biruni,
yes. And Al-Biruni.
Ibn
Battuta, yes. Yes, and yes. Ibn Battuta, Al-Biruni, yes, and Marco Polo. Fahian, there are many. They travel the world, they tour the world for education and exploring the lands. And one very important name you forgot, that is very important name of a very important geographer. Yes. Can anyone guess that name? Can anyone remember that name? Yes. Yes, refer. It is, have you heard about the name of Vidal de la Blache?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Perhaps that was, he was the father of human geography.
Yes, sir.
Though I don't ascribe to the notion that if there is any father of any business, a knowledge branch, but he is considered of, he toured the world extensively and he studied regions. Actually, the concept of region he had a big part to play in the development of geography itself, mainly human geography. So he gave the geography a flavor of regional geography. And what he called regions? He called regions by special name.
Pairs.
Pairs, yes. He called them pairs. So he was very. Actually, if you think deeply, you will find that Marco Polo was also a geographer. And one very important biologist was there. Yes? Yes. What is his name? Yes. One of the most famous biologist name. Naturalist or biologist. Darwin. Darwin. Darwin gone on a world journey on a ship. And some people consider Darwin as a geographer. There is a school of thought that considered Darwin as a geographer. Darwin was actually we call geography mother of all sciences. So in early times it was science, not geography or any or geology. That divisions developed later. So Darwin was on a ship of the world, an expedition of the world. What was that ship called? Yes. What was that ship called? Yes. That ship was called HMS Beagle. That was a government sponsored ship. HMS Beagle. His Majesty's ship Beagle. So he and he found something in that journey, and he got the theory of evolution. Okay. Then there was a very very important. It was and is multidirectional tourism. Multidirectional tourism. Before modern time. And in modern times also, multi-directional tourism. In this tourism, people go and perform many types, many sectors of work. They are doing, they are going for education, they are doing some business also, they are, actually you can say that Darwin was on government business and he was educating himself also, and he educated the world after that. Yes? Okay. So, then there was, there is a very, very important element in tourism, trade routes. Trade routes, ancient trade routes, there were some routes of trades. Can any, can you give example of any route? Yes. Yes. Yes, any route? Yes. Any route you can name? Have you heard of silk route?
Yes, sir.
A big part of tourism was performed on these routes. Silk route comes to India or not? Yes, Silk Route is famous for trading Chinese silk to Europe. Yes. It came to India or not?
Yes, sir.
But if you see the world map closely, you will find that India is not en route from China to Europe. You can go to Europe from China directly. No need to come to India. Yes, India was on Silk Route or not? Azerbaijan was there, Khartoum was there, other Khurasan was there, but India was not on main Silk Route. A branch of Silk Route came to India. You're getting me? A branch, because India was very important, and later on, a great silk production was in India also. So, and then sea routes, these are land routes, and then sea routes. There were two types of routes mainly, on which trade developed. Sea voyages are sea routes. Sea voyages. What are these? These were the voyages or routes on the sea. Sea was a big highway in those days, yes, isn't it? And it is interesting to know that most of the development of astronomy taken place because of these sea voyages.